Sun angle is also considered as the angle at which the sunrise fall on the surface of Earth. So usually altitude angle is also considered as sun angle. Okay. Now, while designing, so we know what kind of the sun path has. So sun rises and sets in sun rises in east and sets in west, but it carries a certain path. Okay. So it can reach a higher altitude during summers, but whereas it reaches a lower altitude during winters. So, and also sometimes it is slightly tilted towards north, or that the path is slightly tilted towards north or south. That is based on the different location, on the geographical location. Okay. So wherever your site is, so the sun path is usually different. Okay. Even if you consider, let's say, now Mysore and Bangalore, there is a very small difference in the sun path. Okay, very small, maybe a few minutes, may not be degrees, but few minutes of angle or this thing, it might be different. So hence, we need to study sun path for each and every site that we are studying. Okay, so we also had studied that microclimate also influences, even though sun path might be in a particular direction or a particular orientation of the sun. But what happens because of the site conditions? Let's say there is a mountain, or let's say there is a big building next to it. Okay, so then you need to understand how the sun path reacts for that particular structure, or let's say mountain natural feature or the structure, so that we can understand what is the shading pattern of that building on your site. Okay, so that you know. So even if you're considering to sun to you get a very good sunlight from a particular direction, but what if there is a obstruction there? What if there is a mountain, there is a tree, there is a, let's say some kind of structure. Okay, so there might be a bridge that is saying, okay, so there might be a big tower that is obstructing the sunlight. So then we need to reconsider the shading pattern, reconsider based on the shading pattern of that particular structure or element. Okay. So starting with orientation, so you must have heard this a lot, or you must be even lot of architects, or even we try to use the term orientation of buildings. Okay, so we'll try to explore orientation in terms of sunlight. Now orientation is also in terms of wind is different. So orientation, I'll just read this. Orientation is positioning of building in relation with seasonal variations of the sun path as well as prevailing wind patterns. Okay, so good orientation can increase the energy efficiency of your home, making it more comfortable to live in. Okay, and cheaper to run, because it makes it more efficient, energy efficient. So you're not using lights unnecessarily, you're not using artificial light, but whereas because of this passive this is considered as passive strategy. Okay, because of giving windows and openings in a particular direction where you can harvest lot of sunlight. So that is why you are trying to reduce the energy consumption in terms of lighting. Same thing, if your orientation is with respect to wind, then you are also doing a lot of harvesting of airflow. So then you are not using energy for, let's say, fan or HVAC systems or AC systems. Okay. So that is how your building becomes very energy efficient, if you do proper orientation. Now orientation is very important aspect coming to all the projects. So especially for tropical countries, where especially for any of these things, but in tropical climates we need a lot of cooling. Okay, and we should consider the orientation in such a way that the building doesn't absorb a lot of heat. Okay. So this is just an image to show that say there is there are two building blocks, one which is having certain projections. So because of the certain projections, again there is some kind of shading. Okay. And another block which is actually C shaped, or you can say U shaped, so in which the central portion, which can be usually used as courtyards or open spaces, so that is shaded. Okay. Because it is located in certain direction, okay, and on the opposite direction of the sunlight. If the cutout, that is the niche that is present in the one block, in this block, if the niche was other side, then it will be completely exposed to sunlight. Okay, So we need to understand what is this. So this is, you can say, the form of building. Yes, the form and also the massing of building. We use these terms. Okay, I think I want to. I'll just tell you about massing also. So massing refers to the structure in three-dimensional form. Yes. So it is a three-dimensional form. That is, what is a mass? Mass is something that occupies space and has weight. Okay. So there is a building mass. So we generally consider this as mass. Now massing, what they have done is, in one example, they have done massing in C-shape, and it is having an open niche, or you can say courtyard, towards a particular direction. Okay. So this is a kind of a massing that is done. So another this thing, massing is a very rectangle block that is a mass, but again it is having vertical, horizontal projections outside. Okay, so that is also. So this is massing. So massing refers to a structural in three-dimensional form, not just outline from a single perspective. It is also the shape that the building possesses. Massing influences the sense of space which building encloses, which helps to define both interior space and exterior shape of the building. Okay, it is not just interiors and other thing; it is also the exterior mass. What kind of the object? What kind of form you are creating? Okay, so that also will lead to certain kind of heat absorption, or you can say it will also help in the cooling of building. Okay, so yeah. So usually when we study, try to study sun path and this thing, so it is not just it is not just about orientation. It is also about the massing, kind of massing we do. Okay, there is also one more concept which is called as mutual shading. Okay, mutual shading can be it is like the shade of one building or one block is falling on other block, and so that is why it is protecting from heat when there is extreme heat or extreme heat from the sunlight. So then we try to do the mutual shading of buildings. So suppose, let's say, if there are two blocks, yes, so then what we do is we try to take one block which is exposed and another block is trying to get shade from the first block. Okay, so that is an answer. It is also considered as mutual shading. I think these exercises will also help you to arrive certain concepts in your design which you are working on now. Okay, so we are considering the location as Delhi, so we can understand how is the sun path this. So for this we need to create a zone. So here you can see the orientation is towards north. Yes, so there can be we can actually create two building blocks which are again one oriented, let's say one oriented towards north south. And another building block which is oriented towards let's say east west. So these are the two blocks that you can see. I think we can give this example. Let's say this is a correct orientation as east west and these things, but a lot of openings if I'm giving in south direction, that is this direction, then a lot of sunlight is also entering into the building. Yes, so yeah, when the depth is less, so the sunlight will penetrate to the complete building. It will heat up the complete building inside. Okay, it's a very interesting this thing. So if you could resolve it, then I think it will be. Let's see now, let's say one building block, which is, so this is again north side. So sunrises, I'll just put the sun path so that it will be very effective. Yes. So this is the sun path. Okay. So we can consider sun path. So this is actually, you can see. So this is sun path, which is showing these things. Okay. Yeah. So now, so this is the movement of sun path. Yes. So this is sun rises in the, yes. Let's say it is, so this is north. So sun rises here. You can see this is how the sun actually moves. Okay. So this is yellow is nothing but sun. It moves in this particular path. Okay. So this is a sun path. Okay. Now, if I select it for, let's say, when is the summer solstice or winter solstice? Yes. Yes, can you see this block?
So
okay. Okay, so let's say this is the sun path. Okay, when is the summer solstice or winter solstice? So we can set that maximum sun path for that particular time. Okay.
June 21st.
June 21st, yes. So June 21st, we are going to take the summer solstice. So here we can see this is the sun path for that particular. Okay. So sun rises, yes, slightly towards this thing. So this is the sun path for Delhi. Okay. So sun rises here and it sets. Okay. And for winter, so summer solstice is usually it is having higher sun angle, altitude angle. But whereas if I consider, let's say December. So this is, I think you can see the winter sun. Okay. So winter sun is again having a lower altitude. Okay. So this is the sun path. So sun rises and it take this particular path and it sets during the, okay. So this is how, what we had created trying to understand sun path. So this is how the sun rises and it sets in the west. Okay. So I'll just, so here actually we can also see the animations, that is annual sun path. So this is showing the annual sun path. Okay. So sun path is just completely, so this is extreme for, let's say, yeah, the yellow what is showing for the winter, and you can also see the during summer, or you can see in middle any other month also. So this is for the month of March, where the sunpath is like this, or let's say if I say October, so every month you can see the sunpath changes. Okay, starting from let's say January, February, okay, again the sunpath is changing. Yes, March. So then it reaches towards June, and again after June, again it starts to come back to these things. Yes, June, July, yes, August, September. So it changes the sunpath for this particular. So this is an example for so I wanted to show you. So this is how the sun actually moves. As you can see, the sun moves. Okay, so what Shalini said was actually this thing. Okay, so if you are having the orientation of building in this particular direction, then what happens here, so if you can see the sun, let's say during after afternoon, yes, so this portion, what you can see, this portion is getting sunlight. So this portion from afternoon, where it is usually the sunlight is very harsh, okay, the atmospheric pressure is also very low, so there is lot of heat that will enter your building block, but whereas this portion is not exposed. So this is actually north side, okay, which is not exposed, but south side is also exposed to lot of sunlight. Now there is a solution for this. So what usually people do is, so south side, what you can do, you can provide a slight overhang. Yes, so we'll provide a small overhang. So this is overhang, you can see this, we can see this thing overhang here. Okay, so then we can see how it is this thing. So because of the overhang, what happens, so this portion is also shaded, okay, with slight overhang, so you can shade the complete south facade. So this way we can also stop the sunlight from the you can allow the sunlight from for the winter, but if it is very hot, then you can avoid the sunlight for let's say other these things. Okay, yes, for other months you can avoid the sunlight based on this length, based on this overhang. Yes, so that is nothing but again shading devices. You can cut the sunlight from the south side. Okay, north side there is no sunlight, direct sunlight, so you can give large openings on the sunlight, so that, and you can also use different materials, like let's say glass, which is allowing less heat gain. You can also use a lot of these things, lot of openings, or you can say large openings, or you can say materials which are, you don't have to have thick walls, you can have thin walls. So, but whereas on south and west side, you can have thick walls on this, because there is lot of sunlight falling on these facades, okay, or these elevations. Yes, south side and west side. Okay, so I actually wanted to show you the shading pattern for this. So this, I think if you can display shadows, okay. Yeah, now I think you can see the shadows. Yes, so the because of the shadow, what is happening, so this is when the sun is let's say towards, yes, because of the overhang, the whole this thing facade is getting, yes, it is getting shaded. Okay, if I want to shade this again, I'll use another similar kind of okay, let's say I'll use another similar kind of So if I'm using, let's say, similar kind of shading for this also, so then what happens? So I get this facade completely shaded. I think I'll just draw a plane here. Yeah, so now you can see the complete portion is shaded. Now what happens, I can give large openings on the south side also. Okay, and based on the these things, based on the overhang, based on the length of these things, I can control whatever the sunlight I want inside the building, or if I don't want, if I want more light, then I'll reduce the overhang of this building so that I can use lot of this thing. So many architects use this concept that this provides actually a balcony space and also it is shading. Okay, and at every these things it is shaded. Okay. Now you can see this portion, this building, yes, is getting shaded because of this. So this is nothing but mutual shading. And the street, or we can say sometimes when you design like courtyards and these things, so the courtyards are also shaded. Okay. Only at certain part of the time, so it is usually shaded. You can see this is shaded during morning. Only afternoon, during for some part of the time, it is exposed to sunlight. Yes, this courtyard. Otherwise, again, it is shaded for the longer period. Yes. So, if I consider this building, so if this building is not existing, then there is lot of sunlight that is hitting this southern wall. Okay. Now the orientation of this, yes, which is on the longer axis of north south, what happens, it is exposed to lot of sunlight. Okay, so even if I'm providing shading devices, what happens at these things? Okay, you can see here, so there is lot of penetration of sunlight when the sun is at lower altitude. Okay, so at lower altitude, even here some of the light is getting penetrated, but again it is comparatively less. Okay, it is shaded for the most part of the day. Okay, so for this we need to design shading devices which will cut down the light which is not required, which will, yes, which will take the light which is required. We usually, when we go out in sun during summers, if you want to see, then we try to cover this. Yes, we try to do this this thing that we try to cover, or we try to provide shade so that we don't get glare. Yes, so that the eye portion is shaded, and we can have a better visibility. Okay, so the same these things I think you can consider for the designing of shading devices also. Okay, if there is lot of glare from one direction, then I'll try to cover my, yes, my eyes from a particular angle so that I can see, or I can get a better visibility, and it can reduce the glare, okay, that is entering into my eyes. Okay, similarly we try to reduce. So this is the ideal or best orientation for hot climate. Okay, but whereas this is the best orientation for cold climates, where I need lot of heat entering my building. Okay, here I don't want lot of heat entering my building. So this is the ideal situation for, let's say, tropical climates, and this is ideal situation or ideal orientation for hot climates. Okay. Now with various combinations and various other forms and these things, I can also create different forms that will help to reduce solar heat gain. Okay, in turn, which is also reducing the energy efficiency, increasing the energy efficiency of the building. Okay, now the orientation which is towards north south, you can see the slab is getting exposed to sunlight, but whereas here also it is getting exposed to sunlight. Okay. But whereas this surface is the exposure is very less compared to the other. Okay, so here also you can provide shading devices, but you need to provide long overhangs so that you are covering the south facade. Okay, so with less use of building material or building mass, you can provide shading for a larger mass. Okay, so or for larger internal area. Okay, so this is considered as the best orientation for, let's say, tropical climate. Okay, so this is considered as ideal this thing. Okay, Now coming to the design of shading devices. Now there is a certain understanding regarding the shading devices. I think we'll go to that. So this is what happens here because of slight overhang on the south side. What happens? The sunlight is not. I am cutting the sunlight so that this portion is not getting heated up. But whereas if the building was oriented in north south, we can see that a lot of heat penetration happens towards west. Okay, even though east there is a lot of penetration of heat, but what happens? East is considered as very soft light, or it contains a very less heat because of the atmospheric. It is during high pressure and it carries less heat. But whereas west and southwest, this thing is very bad. Okay, so usually what people do is they provide thick walls in south and west facade. South and west walls are made very thick, or in fact they use cavity walls where the heat is not continued. Okay, so these of cavity walls, we'll also study the U values of different walls. Okay, so that is in next class. So based on the different orientation, north wall can have less U value. Okay, and or more value U value. Okay, so we can use walls of different thickness and different U values or if different R values in on the basis of direction. Okay, so we can also use massing. Yes, massing we have already this thing. So even trees are considered as shading devices. It is not just building blocks. So trees also, which will again cut down lot of light, that is also helpful for cutting down lot of heat. Okay, so in that way we can see which fortunately the summer sun is having higher altitude than compared to winter sun. So that is why we can use lot of light during winters. Okay, now winters are appearing, you can see like slightly these things, so you need lot of light. Okay, but whereas you don't need light for summer. Okay, so yeah, so this is again this thing which is again shaded. So you can see this portion is again which is having higher mutual shaded or shaded area, that is courtyard or open courtyard areas, or you can say even the streets are also the best example I think would be Jaisalmer. Yes, so Jaisalmer, this is a very interesting city. The whole city is inside the fort, and all the these things are oriented towards north south, because east west all the buildings are there, and that is projection, and each building is projecting slightly inside. Yes, you can see each building is projecting inside, and there is a very small opening on the top, but whereas street are pretty wide. Yes, so and the streets are usually shaded, and Jaisalmer, as you know, the climate is very harsh. It goes it is one of the hottest places in India, where the during summer sometimes the temperature goes up to 46-47, or sometimes they say even the desert reaches a temperature of, let's say, 48-49 also. So this protects them from these things, that is the direct sunlight, and it is mutual shading. Okay, this is mutual shading and also shading the streets inside. Okay, so based on that also you can act, you can design the activities that are in a particular area. Okay, for living room you can have lot of activities for these things. Here you can see they have designed the opening also. So openings can be for these things. Yes, large opening towards north, or depends on the what kind of activities you are planning for different areas. Okay, so based on the different elements, that is the sunlight and also the wind. Okay, you can design the openings and also the building blocks. Okay, so yeah, this is again showing the wind, summer sun and winter sun, which will by the overhang it will cut only the summer sun. Okay, it will allow the winter sun to come inside. Okay, so sun shading devices, as we discussed, so it is allow, it will allow or block different. So there can be mechanical equipment, like there can be lures, there can be fins, there can be jelly walls, or they can even be textiles. Yes, so they are considered as shading devices. Okay, now orientation or massing is considered as passive strategy. Okay, passive strategy, because once you design, once you do that particular form, orientation, mass, you are not doing anything. Okay, you are not doing any kind of movement into that. So because of that, it is considered, it is not active, it is a passive strategy for let's say passive cooling, okay, or passive cooling where the building is getting cooled by itself. Okay, we are not putting any additional mechanism into it. But whereas if I'm using fans to cool, so then it is a mechanical, it is not a passive strategy. Okay. Similarly, but the shading devices can be either passive or mechanical modes. Okay, so it can be the projections, the chajja, what you say, or cantilever blocks or massing. I'm trying to give different these things. Yes, so that is also very well played by, I think, Kanchanjunga. Yes, Charles Correa is very well played with the massing part and these things. Many architects have done the massing very well. Okay. With massing, they can see that how we can shade the building, shade the these things, which actually is very helpful. Okay, they can be either automatic, they can be fixed, or they can be manual also. They can be automatic based on the temperature variations. Okay, based on the climatic seasons, you can actually make automatic systems also. That is what they do in smart buildings or intelligent buildings. You can also be manual, okay, where they can manually operate when they need more sunlight and more these things. Okay, so it is, the primary objective is so that it provides a cool, comfortable atmosphere inside, okay, and it absorbs less heat from the outside. So yes, again, same thing, I'll just, I'll not take this thing. So it is to reduce HVAC loads. HVAC nothing but heating, ventilation and air conditioning. Okay, so that is nothing but AC. Sometimes we have centralized AC, we have split ACs, different types of ACs. So if your building is not responding to climate, or especially the sunlight or the wind direction, then it might need certain additional or mechanical modes to achieve that particular thermal comfort. So that is when we need a lot of AC systems. Okay, so so then there is more consumption of energy, and HVAC or light does not consume more energy as compared to, because nowadays you are having LED lights, LED lamps, LED, which will consume very less energy as compared to the old CFL or one tungsten lights, which used to consume a lot of energy, but whereas LED consumes very less energy, but natural sunlight, it will not just carry the light, it is also carrying certain kind of UV rays, which will try to kill bacteria and which are other benefits. Okay. but whereas we study that the fan uses lot of, or the cooling these things, devices, equipments or appliances, they use lot of cooling or heating devices, appliances, they use lot of energy as compared to the lighting appliances. Yes, lighting equipments. Okay, so that is why we need to try to maintain thermal comfort. Is very important. Try to have as much as passive strategies so that your building becomes more energy efficient. Okay. So it is also used to prevent glare. Sometimes the glare is also because the light is reflected from other building. Okay, neighboring building which is having glass. So sometimes light is reflected from the neighboring building. Sometimes it is because of the eastern sunlight or western sunlight. So then we need to cut the glare. Okay, which is again causing a lot of discomfort or for visibility. Okay. So if we especially designing classrooms and these things, so we need to see that the sunlight is not creating a glare. Okay. Yep. And use daylight availability. So as far as in daytime you are getting sunlight, you try to harvest, use this daylight as much as possible so that we can reduce energy consumption. Okay. So to create a sense of security, internal shading devices, yes. And that is privacy and other things. Now problems with this is, yeah, sunpath usually different. Sunpath and wind direction are usually different, or sometimes it is same direction we are getting sunpath and wind also. So that is why we need to create a design based on both, based on the sunpath and also based on the wind direction. Okay. Yeah. There will be need of admitting controlled levels of diffused daylight. In most cases, there will be a requirement of views of the window. We need a lot of views, but at the same time, we need to cut the sunlight. Okay. So there are again, these are again lowers that are used in the openings. So it can be used inside, it can be used outside, or it can be used in the middle plane also. Okay. Sometimes there are curtain walls where the in middle they are using. So these can also be operable, where you can adjust the angles of the lowers for the light during winter and close during summers. So based on that also you can use. Okay, so based on the colors, even fabric also acts as a shading devices. Okay, it is not just the this thing. Even trees also acts as shading devices. Now what we are going to design is mainly, first we'll try to study, there are basically three types of shading devices that are used in external facade of a building. Okay, so first one is horizontal shading device, yes, where you can see the projection is horizontal, where we see the building block, what we did animation. So that is also providing horizontal shading devices, something like this. It is trying to protect from the, now this again it is having the pergolas, what we say, so they are again intermediate, so there is a small gap. So this is also used, this can also be used, so sometimes they use it for to get a better some kind of elevation or massing, to reduce massing. Okay, sometimes they use bamboos or other materials also. It is not just concrete or this thing, some other materials, so it can also be used like this. It is mainly to cut the sunlight. Okay, so it can also be used vertical or combination of both, so that you get a better shading or lot of shading, and you get lot of wind also. So now wind can pass through this, but whereas sunlight will not pass through this. Okay, now there is one more which is called as vertical shading devices, which is usually called as fins. Yes, it is also called as vertical louvers. So on the left you can see that is showing the window which is having vertical shading devices or fins. In the middle figure you can see the same vertical this thing shading devices in plan. Okay, so you can have a desired angle. So based on the solar angle or sunpath, I can adjust my louvers so that it is cutting a particular sunlight, and it is bringing in the wind direction. Okay, so and it is sometimes they can use adjustable, where they use some panels of let's say wooden panels, or sometimes they use concrete panels or certain this thing, so that they can adjust. It can be pivoted and they can adjust based on their requirement. It can also be fixed, or it can be part of the building, or your building orientation, building massing can also be used so that it acts as a vertical shading device. Okay. Now third one is combination of both vertical and horizontal shading device. Yes, so yes, vertical shading devices are vertical, yes, horizontal. So if I'm having a combination of both, it is called as egg crate. Okay, in the view you can see it is a combination of both. So there are boxes, which is again, so these are used, this particular arrangement is used in very extreme climates. Okay, so this is, I think you can also say it is a simplified, it is a another version of jali. Okay, jali walls also have small openings, which is again, it is not called as accurate, but you can say the accurate devices, the projection is more, but whereas jali walls, the wall itself is having small openings. Okay, so here also they try to give smaller openings, but whereas the projection is more, and these are called as accurate or shading devices. So these are also used in very extreme climate, where there is lot of sunlight, that is you need to cut lot of sunlight from different angles. Okay, so you can see in the above plan where they are trying to cut the sunlight in terms of only certain part of the day the sun is entering, whereas other part of the day sunlight is not entering. And even because of the sun angle, that is the section, in the section also you can see the lot of sunlight is getting cut. Okay, because of the shading device. So this is called as accurate shading devices. Okay, so there might be building mass next building next to your building. Sorry, that is also creating lot of shade. It can be trees also which are creating lot of shade. So these are different shading devices, you can say the horizontal, yes, outrigger system, that is pergolas and these things, horizontal stripes, multiple blades, so that we can use it as for elevation treatments and this thing. So on the left it is showing view, and in the middle it is showing the plan of that particular kind of arrangement. And it is also showing what is a kind of orientation. So usually south orientation they try to use this, east and west they try to use this particular this thing. And towards north, we don't have much of sunlight, so we don't need direct sunlight, so we don't need shading devices. Okay, we might need certain these things to protect from the water that is seeping into the openings. Okay, but we don't need shading devices towards north. Okay. So this is again the same thing. Okay, so that was about shading devices. So in next class, we'll try to calculate what is the angle. There are two angles, that is vertical shading angle, horizontal shading angle. So based on that, we'll try to design shading devices, that is horizontal and vertical shading devices. Okay. Yeah. Is it clear? Any doubts regarding this thing for today's class? Okay. So today's, you can say today's class is more about orientation massing. What kind of orientation you have to have for a particular climate, what kind of massing, and for shading you can have different devices, that is horizontal, vertical, or combination of both, that is accurate devices. Okay. Okay. So if you have any doubts further, you can ask. Okay. Yeah. Okay. I hope this was useful. You can also see, I think I'll show you the animation for this. I think, yes. Okay. You can see the shading, that is, so this annually they are showing it for one particular day, that is 1st of March. How the, yes. How the shading and that happens day and night. So this is the maximum and this is the minimum, or you can say hourly. So this is during east midnight and this is during the west. Okay. So based on this, I can say that I should not provide openings here because of two building blocks which are located. Or you can see, I think this portion, yeah, it is exposed almost throughout the day, it is exposed to sunlight. Okay. But whereas we'll try to see this, you can see this facade and compare these two facades, a facade with overhang with a shading device, without a shading device. We can see the arm with this. You can see most of the day it is shaded. Okay, but whereas this, it is not shaded. So if you are providing a small overhang, so then this portion will also be shaded throughout the year. Okay. So this is for this thing, let's say for June, which is having a lot of heat, which on this thing. So we can see this portion is completely shaded, okay, throughout the day. Even for this thing, so during yes, summers, what happens? Let's say for this March, April, or May, or June. Okay. April, May, when there is extreme sunlight, where you can see. So morning sunlight is there, okay, and afternoon, okay, post these things. But whereas for summer solstice, so this is shaded for this thing. So based on that, I can change my orientation. If I slightly tilt towards southwest, then I think even I'm not getting any sunlight for that particular thing. But because of these things, I might have there might be a chance that I get sunlight on this facade also. Now for this thing, let's see. So this facade is also getting light during morning and during, yes, during the sunset. So this, even the north facade is slightly getting light. Okay, you can see here. So north facade here, it is getting light. Okay. So first we need to understand the sun path, and then we can understand what kind of shading is required for particular in particular direction of the building or building block. Okay.